I've had the incredible privilege of seeing, I think, one of the most remarkable journeys of modern history. The rise of the Republic of Korea, of South Korea. Korea is a country that I know very well. I've lived in it for 11 years of my adult life, over three decades, starting way back in the 1970s. But every time I come back, it's changed.
Seeing South Korea's resiliency from their people who serve their country is a really, really powerful thing.
Korea's been an amazing experience. It's my first time in Asia. I think it's also been a really cool experience to talk with the people that we've interacted with from other universities.
We came here at a particularly eventful time, even by, I would say, Korea's very high standards of change and dynamism. And it was very heavily polluted. And I think that really focused our minds, particularly in the first few days, on the challenges that Korea, as successful as it is, economically, in terms of its development path, in addressing today's issues. And so we had a mix of that, I think, throughout the week.
What was really surprising was being at the DMZ and how demilitarized zone, but it's the most militarized zone in the world. Just seeing the unity on that strip of land was really impactful for me.
There's only so much you can learn in a classroom, and just being able to hear the propaganda music and the tangible aspect of this has been really informative.
The day that we were at the DMZ, watching on a cell phone held by one of our Chinese students as she interpreted the Chinese reporting on the North Korean leader Kim Jong-un meeting with Xi Jinping. I mean, it was all very, you know, not just ripped from the headlines. We felt like we were experiencing the headlines as we were around these places.
I'm becoming increasingly interested in the humanitarian implications of reunification on the Korean Peninsula and sort of all of the issues surrounding what the needs of the North Korean people specifically will be.
This kind of opportunity to go out into for most students is an unfamiliar environment and get on-the-ground experience is, I think, one of the things that makes the Freeman Spogli Institute for International Studies a place where we are nurturing encouraging people who are going to be doers as well as thinkers. My experience has been that there is no substitute for experience.
Just looking at how far things have developed on the Korean Peninsula since the war and where a lot of the different leaders are hoping to see Korean policy, U.S. policy, and sort of U.N. influence in the region going, I think all of those really overlap with humanitarianism in ways that I didn't anticipate.
Maybe for many of them was the most, in a way, surprising to them in terms of their preconceptions or expectations was the meeting we had with General Brooks, the commander of the U.S. Forces Korea, a four-star army general. I was really kind of gratified to hear some of our non-American students, including from China and Russia in particular, say this would never happen in their country, that they would have a chance to sit down for more than an hour with a top military officer in a, you know, the quintessential hotspot and have a very frank and open discussion for an hour or so about all kinds of things.
Having that firsthand experience of interacting with people from different cultures, I mean, not just in the academic setting, but just say over a beer, building those personal relationships allow you to get more out of it in a way that you wouldn't normally get.
It's great to see Korea, a place I know well, through their fresh eyes.
In addition to that level of empathy that you build when you travel and you meet people from different cultures and different places, there's also a level of self-reflection. It makes you more cognizant of your actions in your own country. Maybe you can do more.
Another cool opportunity we had was going to the Korean History Museum. To see it from the Korean perspective in Korea was a unique opportunity. I think being with Ambassador Stephens and walking alongside her as we passed through exhibits was also really exciting. I remember instances where she'd point to a student protester and said, "Oh yes, I remember talking with this student," or "I remember being in Korea when this event happened."
The treat for me is to get to know these students in a way that's not possible on the campus. I know when I get back to campus that every time I see them, whether from a distance or in a class, that we're going to feel a very special bond and feel that we have a different kind of relationship of a shared experience.